Heads up, humans! Argument by Claudia Alarcón. If you're like most young people, you've probably embraced technology. You communicate with friends via videos and filters. You have vast numbers of songs and shows within reach. You can get items delivered to your home the same day you ordered them without leaving the house. These benefits of technology are easy to see. Perhaps you take it further and are one of those who believe that technology does not just add fun and convenience to our lives, but is actually the answer to most of our problems, even problems that are caused by technology itself. In the very near future, one of the biggest of these problems is likely to be that many jobs now held by humans will be done by some combination of artificial intelligence and automated machine. If you're tempted to shrug off concern about this phenomenon because you assume that the wonders of technology will somehow create new and better jobs, you should be aware that research tells another story. As part of the generation that will arguably be most affected by these changes, it's in your interest to stay informed rather than simply hope for the best. There is no argument that many jobs now held by humans will be replaced by some form of advanced technology. According to a new report by a multinational accounting and consulting firm based in London, 38% of U.S. jobs are at high risk of being replaced by robots and artificial intelligence over the next 15 years. The report estimates the percentage of jobs lost to automation in Britain will be 30%, with 35% in Germany and 21% in Japan. This change is already underway. Shipping companies have made headlines with self-driving trucks carrying cargo across the country. Rideshare companies have been testing self-driving taxis in Pennsylvania and Arizona. Once more of our trucks and taxis drive themselves, what will happen to the people who held jobs as drivers? In the U.S., roughly 180,000 taxi drivers, 600,000 rideshare drivers, and 3.5 million truck drivers could end up displaced. This number is greater than the population of Houston, San Antonio, Dallas, Austin, and Fort Worth combined. Will all these people find some other source of employment? Or will the numbers of unemployed grow as the out-of-work drivers are joined by the millions of others who have been displaced by artificial intelligence and robots? Technology fans claim that the fears that robots will lead to massive unemployment are unfounded. They say that people who are displaced from jobs will find new and better occupations that will be created by the economic shift. They suggest that a factory worker whose task on the assembly line is now completed by a machine might instead become someone who services the machine, for example. Or that there could be a rise in jobs in sectors that are harder to automate, such as healthcare. The last 200 years, we've had an incredible amount of automation, argues MIT economist David Autor. We have tractors that do the work that horses and people used to do on farms. We don't dig ditches by hand anymore. We don't pound tools out of wrought iron. We don't do bookkeeping with books. But this has not, in net, reduced the amount of employment. However, there is plenty of evidence to suggest that it's going to be different going forward. The introduction of the labor-saving tractor did indeed free up some farmers to plant more crops and others to take on different sorts of work. But the kind of automation combined with artificial intelligence being developed today doesn't just do the physical work of humans. It can do much of the high-level mental work, too, faster and more effectively. In the past, newly freed laborers often went on to work in startup industries that benefited from their availability. Today, the new industries are unlikely to need many human bodies or minds because technology can do the work for less cost. Jerry Kaplan, an artificial intelligence expert who's founded multiple technology startups, has written a book called Humans Need Not Apply. In it, he lays out the risks of our new era. He explains what's cutting edge and poised to increase: systems that learn from experience and therefore don't need to be programmed, as we commonly understand the term. Not only will machines be able to do work that we think of as requiring human judgment and skill, such as fixing electrical problems, painting a house, or writing a news story, they will also be able to do work that people simply can't. Unlike humans, who are limited in the scope and scale of experiences they can absorb, these systems can scrutinize mountains of instructive examples at blinding speeds. They are capable of comprehending not only the visual, auditory, and written information familiar to us, but also the more exotic forms of data that stream through computers and networks, he writes. Kaplan is mainly referring to the future he predicts based on his perspective as an expert in the tech world. But already, we can see the consequences. There is no evidence that recent advances in technology have so far offered the majority of workers better pay or positions. In fact, the opposite seems to be true. A report by the National Bureau of Economic Research found that between 1990 and 2007, automation lowered both the number of jobs available and the amount those jobs paid. We estimate large and robust negative effects of robots on employment and wages, write the authors of the study. Renowned theoretical physicist Stephen Hawking is concerned about massive job loss and how that could affect the stability of our society. The automation of factories has already decimated jobs in traditional manufacturing, says Hawking. The rise of artificial intelligence is likely to extend this job destruction deep into the middle classes, with only the most caring, creative, or supervisory roles remaining. Hawking emphasizes that we live in a world where financial inequality is growing, not diminishing. He believes that many people can see their standard of living and their ability to earn a living at all disappearing. This is a frightening scenario. It's tempting to avoid thinking about it, especially because solutions aren't obvious. But the first step toward avoiding the employment problems we might face is acknowledging them. As someone with your future on the line, don't let anyone tell you that technology is automatically going to create a healthy economy for everyone. If we don't want a bleak future for most of us, we have to prioritize human well-being, even as we take advantage of what technology offers.